In statistical analysis, we compute correlations to determine how one or more variables are tied to each other, is there is a relationship between one or two. And I really like this cartoon, which is about the debate about correlation and causation, and you may see correlation, but it's not a proof for causation. There's a correlation between drownings and ice cream sales, but ice cream sales don't cause drownings. It's just that ice cream sales and drownings increase during summertime. So correlation, even with this caveat, is an important statistical tool for us to analyze how variables behave in each other's presence. For categorical variables, we can use cross tabulations, and the test associated with it is chi-square test. And for continuous variables, one way of looking at the correlation between two continuous variables is to draw a scatter plot and see if there is a trend. You can also estimate a correlation coefficient. If there are continuous variables, we can use Pearson correlation. And if there are categorical variables, we can use tetrachoric correlation. Here's the mathematical notation on how to compute correlations. My advice would be to consult your stats book on these details. When you're using statistical software, they can readily compute these numbers. But essentially, you're looking at the deviations from mean for both variables and the multiplication of both, and then you take the sum of it and divide it by the number of observations, and that's your covariance. And then when you take the covariance and divide it by standard deviation for each variable, that is the correlation. More important than the mathematical notation is to understand what correlation means. Let's say you have two variables, x and y, and they are positively correlated, and we computed the correlation coefficient. It's 0.74. To visualize that, if two variables have a positive correlation of 0.74, this is the trend you would see. That is, when one increases, so does the other. If they have a negative correlation, see this small negative sign here, you would see a downward sloping curve that as one increases, the other one declines. And when there is no correlation between the two variables, you see this sort of a random pattern. So in our data set of beauty and evaluation, we plotted these results, and I fit this regression line, and it's very weak correlation. This is the R-square value, which we will discuss later. But you could see that there is a positive trend that as beauty increases, so does the teaching evaluation. But it's not that clear-cut proof there. So if you were to compute the bivariate correlation, the correlation coefficient, which is called the Pearson correlation coefficient, it's 0.189. And that's the correlation between beauty and evaluation, or beauty score and the teaching evaluation. It's the same here. It's sort of a matrix. So is it statistically significant? Yes. Again, we will not discuss the statistics behind it or the math behind it. This is for hypothesis testing later. But to demonstrate that if you have a variable and the variable has a positive correlation, it may not even appear as a positive correlation just by looking at it. But when you compute the correlation coefficient, it's 0.189. And based on the statistical theory, we can see that it's a statistically significant correlation. We'll discuss that later. How do you create a scatter plot and compute the correlation coefficient in SPSS? We click on Graphs, Chart Builder, select the scatter plot, drag this here, and click on Normalize Beauty Score, bring it on x-axis. Teaching evaluation score goes on y-axis, and that's pretty much it. We click OK, and the output comes in here, and now we fit a regression line to it, so we double click on this output, and click here. It says, do you want to fit a linear regression line? I'm not going to attach the label, so I deselect this. You can see this is a dialog box, and I say apply, and say close here, and there's the regression line. Then for correlation, we click on analyze, then on correlate, bivariate, pick the two variables, which are the beauty score and the teaching evaluation, click on OK.